What up, you two? We got another beautiful morning here. It's about 50 degrees out right now. We got two units not cooling. I don't know how much video I'll get on this, but we got a customer that wants to hang out with me this morning. But we got two large carrier units here. Might have some economizer issues if I had to guess. These are probably less than a year old, and the economizers have been operating. So I'll give a video I can. We're gonna dig into these and see what we can find. So after initial inspections, we've got an A126, an A058, and an A152. So high pressure circuit A, 58B, circuit B says the switch failed, and then 152 is basically a lockout. I was wrong, these things are about a year old, and they run constant. You can see our coil's just a bit dirty. So before we can do anything else, we're gonna have to get the coil cleaned. Filters are dirty as well. You got a pre-filter and a bag type filter. So this is food processing area, so they've got these things run 24/7 basically, and they got a whole lot of dust inside. So before we can do much else, we've got our hoses. We have to run about, I don't know, 300 or 400 feet. Right by the airport, so it's loud. There's our water access. So we got a long way to go, but we'll get the hose strung out. I got a maintenance guy helping me and get these things cleaned up. This one's gonna be the same thing, same issues. No doubt about that. Coal's gonna be dirty. So what we got now. Get in here. Go down to alarms. Current enter 127. That's going to be another high pressure, I believe. 57. 152. So we got a little bit different alarms on this one, but I can't do a whole lot without clean coils and clean filters, so let's get them clean, see where we go from there. Getting ready to wrap this one up. This one's been running for the last couple hours while I clean the second unit. See, our holes are cleaned. I'm gonna get some grease on those bearings. We got no alarms on that one. just starting this one back up. We're gonna let it cycle, make sure we don't have any alarms or anything going on with it, and have to address the one that had an actuator failure, which I'm sure is, that was the T617. I'm sure that's what we're still seeing. Yeah, that's our only alarm now, so we should at least have cooling, and I'll investigate that. So let me know what y'all think. Leave a comment. Hit that subscribe button. We'll see y'all on the next one.